Already you can see that sharp head movement of Amir Khan that's caused by the Tourette syndrome that he spoke about earlier. He will overcome that and focus on the contest ahead of him.
He's had to deal with this type of situation his whole life. This is nothing new to him. For Umar, it's something that he's gonna have to deal with in this fight. It's something that's gonna distract him, kind of get his mind off of the actual fight.
Let's go, guys, action.
Waka Umar will be well prepared. Bashir Ahmad is a fine mixed martial arts man, the real pioneer of that sport in Pakistan. And if he's putting a man up in the 1FC cage, you know he'll be in good shape and ready to fight.
Beautiful setup for the head kick.
Good speed with that foot as well as he brings it up. The jab, he comes forward, he leans, he skips into it, which adds just a little bit of extra zest to it when he connects.
Khan just looks so relaxed on the feet right now. He's just kind of setting the pace, setting the tempo, everything. Well, Khan looks a little uneasy right now. He's kind of can't get his rhythm.
Seemed a bit low, that one, borderline.
Keep your hands up, keep your hands up, keep your hands up.
Referee calls upon them to keep going, which caught Waka Umar off guard. Oh, well, I think Waka Umar was expecting a little bit of a pause. He felt that there might have been a low blow. To be fair, it looked to me to be borderline rather than low. We'll see a replay of it, I suspect. But as he was looking at the referee, you've got to defend yourself at all times. Olivier Coste said, fight on. And Amir Khan's concentration was as focused as you would expect from that young man. He took the opportunity that presented itself, didn't wait for the referee to say anything further than fight on. And he is your winner. He improves to 2-1 in his professional mixed martial arts record. 2-0 in the 1FC cage. Another good victory for Amir Khan and a lesson in professionalism. Fight on until the referee says otherwise. There's the low blow potentially from the left foot. Again, still Waka Umar looking at the referee, waiting to see what he's going to do. No waiting around from Amir Khan. His attack was ruthless and he finished it there and then. Singapore has a mixed martial artist to get excited about. That fight brought to you by Canon, delighting you always. Here's the official decision from Anthony Suntai.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a halt to this battle. At a minute 25 seconds of round number one, for your winner by knockout from the red corner, Amir Khan!
This fight brought to you by Fairtex. Be inspired. Fast start from Bashir Ahmad. I wonder if that is what he thinks is the secret to victory here, having spent so long on a plane this week.
Yeah, Bashir wants to, he wants to add pressure. He wants to get, you know, Amir Khan uncomfortable and get him up against the cage and teach him what this level of MMA is all about. But look at the knees coming from Khan. Oh, man, those are brutal. Here comes, look at the elbows raining down.
It was the knees that took over because Bashir made a good start with his fists. But those knees just took over.
Work the finish, work the finish.
Oh, those knees to the body just hurt. They just take all the wind out of you.
Careful, back on the head, careful.
And that body will not be in the condition that Bashir Ahmad would have liked. I've done that to Asia to American leg on a plane several times. I would not like to do it twice in 1 week and then jump to the cage. Not against this man, anyway.
That height from that clinch was really impressive. You could see the difference there in the, when it got, they got into the clinch. Bashir's got a half guard here, which is not, you know, a bad position to be in, but he's got to get off his back. He can't allow Khan to flatten him out on his back like this. He's got to try to push away, but those elbows just keep raining down. But for Bashir to handle that onslaught from Khan.
Oh, he's got some distance there, but he backed off.
Oh, back up to the feet.
I thought for a moment Amir might take advantage of just finding that bit of leverage and space so that he could rain those punches down. Good left jab from Khan.
Oh, nice right jab. Oh, the big right hand.
That certainly hurt him, didn't it?
Here come the knees again. I don't think Bashir likes that. I think he needs to stay tight to the cage here to avoid those knees.
He's always in good shape, Bashir. That's how he was able to take this fight at such short notice. But really, this is not the preparation he would have wanted.
Oh, no. He did spend 8 weeks out there at Team Quest Thailand. You know, so he did get a good training preparation for this fight. That's the only reason why he took this fight is because he felt he was truly ready. So he's in shape for this battle.
Exchanging knees and
see, but with his hips up against the cage like that, he can't add that same kind of leverage that he was doing earlier.
Sure. No back lift, as it were.
Yeah, they hurt, but they're more annoying than anything else.
Stop. Middle.
Joey Lapid takes him to the center of the cage. Right uppercut from Khan and a left hand, but Bashir comes back.
He's just those knees again. Look at those knees. He's got
nice
uppercut
again from Bashir. That's a dangerous weapon he's got there.
I don't think he likes that clinch at all, so keeping him up against the cage is really going to negate a lot of the power that he has coming from those knees.
He's been impressive in his last two fights, Amir Khan. First round victories on both occasions. This looks a little bit tougher for him from time to time.
One more action.
And that right hand that brought those super looking uppercuts in.
Ooh, surprising. Amir Khan wanted to go to the ground. Let's see if he's got a jiu-jitsu game here. Bashir back into the half guard. He's just kind of holding him, controlling that posture. He's got to try to move.
Locked up Khan's right leg. Breathing hard, Bashir, isn't he?
Let's get that full guard, Bashir.
Yeah, he is. That's a lot of weight to cut. He cut almost 11 kilos this week. That is a tremendous task under, you know, and then you got to jump inside this cage.
Push and move, full guard. Full guard. Come on, front position.
But Amir Khan looks comfortable. He's got that pressure coming down on the shoulder.
Front position.
Right there into his face. It's hard for Bashir to do anything with that kind of pressure there.
Amir's right leg all tied up. Look at how he's trying to free it with his hand there.
Bashir tries
to reassert the control on that leg. Perhaps killing a bit of time, Bash. 40-odd seconds left in this round. Nobody will welcome that belt more than him, I would suggest. When it comes,
this is blue belt against blue belt in the jiu-jitsu game, and they're really just kind of like they're not really being that active. I would recommend that we probably get a stand up here because there's not a lot of action going on. But we only got 15 seconds left in the round. The referee might let him ride it out.
As we've seen once before, Amir is the first to stand up. Last time he backed off. Looks like he might do it again, but the round comes to an end. Well, Bashir Ahmad has made it into the second round. Your views on the first round, Mitch?
Oh, look at these knees to the body. That first one hurt him, and you can see Bashir just dropping his arm down, and then right there, oh, those knees to the body are devastating. Dropped him, and he just jumped all over him. But that right hand coming from Bashir.
That's the dangerous weapon for Bashir, the overhand right and that uppercut as well. That's what Amir Khan has to be very, very careful of. And let's not forget, he's been training all this while for a completely different opponent. So he's not been thinking much about that right hand.
No, and the right hand comes out of nowhere. It's hard to hear. It's hard to see coming.
You're hitting him.
Yeah. When you're backing up, he's hitting you. Okay. What are you going to do? Come forward.
Damn right. And when you get in that tie clinch, body lock.
Okay. Let's go, buddy. Keep it up.
So 5 minutes down, potentially here, 10 right. More minutes to come.
Okay. Well, you could hear Khan gets into that clinch, he's devastating with those knees. So Bashir's coach is rightly recommending to get a body lock and prevent him from actually throwing those knees, which is a great strategy.
It's a good left hand from Amir Khan. Nice left hook it was. It's a rangy left hook as well. He's got long levers. Oh, left hand from Bashir. It's exciting when these two stand up and throw leather.
Grab the gauge, grab the gauge.
Still Bashir breathing hard. We can't fault him for that.
He's got to try to get an underhook here. There comes the underhook. Now he can spin him around just like that. That's how you gain control of the cage. I'm surprised Bashir's not attempting more takedowns. I think it's because he's scared about the clinch. That's good pressure.
Amir gets a little bit of room, and he'll use those knees straight away, bringing them up into that rib cage.
This battle right here is so tough. See, he's got the double underhooks. Oh, yeah, he's just got one underhook. And he goes right into the takedown, right back on top. Quite impressed with Khan's wrestling game. He's actually been able to control Bashir, and Bashir has been extremely effective in a lot of his takedowns in previous matches.
Lock down that leg. Left arm lock down. Left elbow. Left arm underhook. Elbow left arm. Left arm lock down.
Come on, good position.
You can hear the corner calling out for the left arm underhook, and that's really just to start moving the hips because he's keeping his position solely on top. Bashir can't do anything until he gets that left arm underneath Amir Khan's arm so he can start moving around. So he can be a little bit more offensive in his guard, because right now he's just lying there.
12 years the age difference here. Bashir Khan is, Bashir Ahmad has dedicated his life to mixed martial arts, really. He's a judge, he's a referee, he's a coach in Pakistan, and as you can see, he's a fighter.
See, he used that underhook to actually come back up to his feet.
Knees again from Khan as he gets pushed into the cage wall.
That's it, good underhook. Pull him off and lock your hands.
Directly above us here at cage side in the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. Knee to the stomach. That's been Khan's major weapon in the stand-up so far.
Lock those hands.
You can just see the energy bar just draining with every single one of those knees. And now he's got double underhooks, though, so now he can actually start working some control. He has both arms in a body lock. Referee calling for action. He needs to see some movement.
Final 2 minutes of this second round. More knees from Khan. And that stomach and those rib cage, that rib cage will be sore.
This jockeying for position they have up against the cage is so draining. It's so hard to control for position.
Speaking of Bashir being sore at the weigh-in, he was telling me he was still sore from the quick workout he had in DC to establish whether or not he could take this fight, whether he was in good enough shape. What a trial it's been for him. Referee Joey Lapita takes them back to the center of the cage. This is where we've seen exciting stuff, just before they get into a clinch. And where Bashir's best work often comes. Good left jab from Amir Khan. That was rod-like. And there's another one. Follows it up with the takedown. Good work from the Singaporean.
The fatigue is definitely settling in on Bashir.
Position.
Let's see if we can work to improve this position. Bashir's trying to stay active, but those punches just don't have anything behind them.
Nice work.
Tried a little elbow to the side of the head there as well, Bashir.
Those can hurt.
Yeah.
Those can definitely
hurt. For sure
hurt.
They can, yeah.
Stop.
Joey Lapita stopped the action.
Nice for action. Okay.
He wasn't satisfied with the level of action. And so he stands him up again. That's probably to Bashir's advantage because he can do that kind of thing. A left and a right. His best work has been there. Bashir's cut badly over the forehead, I think. Perhaps between the eyes there. It looks just in the middle of the forehead.
It looks to be right underneath his eye. And that could have been a headbutt.
Well, Amir Khan took a long look at it as well as the round finished. It's not easy to see where that cut is it? But clearly there's some damage there, and Bashir's corner will be working furiously on that as we look at Amir Khan, who must at this stage, Mitch, be thinking that he's got the fight.
Three big deep breaths, okay? Hey,
When you're backing him up, you're winning. Let's back him up, okay? Breathe.
Hey,
remember, he's fucking tired. You push it, okay? You push him. He's giving up takedowns now. You attack. All right, we'll finish him off this round. Let's keep the pressure on him. Doing great. Okay, keep those hands up and move. You move.
Heath Sims giving plenty of positive encouragement to Amir Khan. Keep those hands up and move, he says. Well, he'll be spurred on by the fact that Bashir Khan has got a problematic cut.
Towel.
Still hard to see exactly where
look
it is.
Look at that. It's right at the edge of his left eye, right by the eyebrow.
On the inside of that left eye.
Oh, man, that's just going to... Right, that's such a bad place to be because the blood is just going to flow into the eye. You can hear... Khan's corner saying to push the pace, to bring it, to attack.
Ready?
Let's see what happens in this third and final round.
Bashir Khan's problems weren't big enough already. He's now got that to deal with. And Amir Khan brings the takedown into his list of problems.
Khan has definitely added a new element to his game, working with the high-level wrestling at Evolve Mixed Martial Arts. You can see just his takedowns are very impressive.
I was looking to get your opinion on exactly what the state of play is here, Mitch, but then we decided to listen in on the corner instead. You presumably have Amir quite a way ahead.
Yeah, Khan is definitely ahead in the totality of this fight. You can see he's controlling most of the positions. He's taking down Bashir almost at will. And you can, I mean, the cut is definitely, you can see the blood just sliding down into that eye right there. But it looks to be okay. It looks like it's just trickling down the nose. But Khan is definitely in control of this fight. Bashir needs to finish Khan to win.
Yeah, the cut looked pretty bad when it happened. They did a pretty good job on it, I think, between rounds. Joe LePeyton's had a moment to look at it. He seems satisfied that he can continue. Nice left hand from Bashir.
Yeah,
missed wildly with that kick.
The cutmen in 1FC are absolutely spectacular, so they're going to definitely take care of the fighter.
Right hand just brushed Amir Khan, if indeed it hit him at all. No trouble for the Singaporean, who is now pushed up against the cage and must be thinking that he's got this fight pretty much in his own control. Just has to make sure he doesn't do any huge mistakes. 3:15 left in this final third round.
But Bashir does pack one-punch knockout power, so he could, you know, you can't count him out yet. You know, he's an absolute warrior. He is still hanging in there.
That's why he's got to keep his mind on the game, despite probably being ahead.
But the fight is not going to be won in this clinch position. Unless he's going actively for takedowns, which he's not.
Stop.
What's Bashir got to do, Mitch? Presumably get a bit of distance there and throw those bombs?
Yeah, he's got to just separate and just unload that right hand.
Time
is called. They got to check out this cut. You can see it's actually getting into his eye.
You can see the amount of blood that's on the Amir Khan's body, exactly how much his opponent is bleeding.
Here.
Joey LePeyton asking for Amir Khan to be wiped down as well. We think it was an elbow that caused the cut, and I think we can take a look at that now. So watch Amir Khan's elbow. Oh, yes, that was it, wasn't it? Left elbow as Bashir Khan was coming in, right on the inside corner of the left eye.
That was a beautifully timed left elbow.
Fantastically
just
timed.
Snuck right in there, opened him up.
He used Bashir's momentum. Oh! Bashir slipped. It was his punch that was the spectacular one. And Amir Khan's taking advantage of the slip.
Get it.
2.5 minutes left.
Keep moving. Elevate.
What a good chin we've seen
from
Amir Khan.
You gotta move.
Because Bashir packs a mean punch, and that was a great example.
Khan definitely has a good chin. That was a very, very good right hand.
I think Joey LePeyton's looking at that cut because it's opened up again. He's got a good view of it there. You can see looking right down. And as Bashir lies on his back, it's going to fall right into his eye. It's going to obscure any kind of vision that he has from that left eye. He's blinking hard.
Time.
Joey Lapete, the call for time again, and I think we all know why. He wants to clean up the mess. And I'm not so sure that we'll go much beyond this. It won't have gone any better, that's for sure, since the last time they looked at it.
Bashir is a warrior. He doesn't want this fight to be stopped by the technicality.
It'd be a real shame if it's finished this way.
Yeah.
For all he's been through this week. But it is over. And to be fair, it's the right decision, isn't it? Because it's a bad cut. It's obscuring his vision quite clearly. Bashir Ahmad is an absolute hero for taking this fight in the first place, for going through what he's gone through. Two flights, Asia to America and back again. Looked absolutely exhausted at the weigh-in, but he's done an absolutely fine job to take this into the third round against the man who shows great promise every time we see him. And the one thing that I think he showed in this contest that perhaps we haven't seen before is a really good chin.
Yeah, he definitely showcased a new set of skills. He added wrestling to his arsenal to really expand on his MMA knowledge. And he's not just a striker. He is a complete mixed martial artist.
We've seen that hat before, and he's wearing it with pride. Once again, he's improved his record to 3-1, unbeaten in a one championship cage, 20 years old. He'll be 21 in November. Fighting out of Evolve MMA, where he gets tremendous experience in so many martial arts.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Joey Lapete calls a halt to this bout at 3:20 of round number two. For your winner, via doctor stoppage, Amir Khan!
Yabo against Khan, brought to you by Naga World, the best integrated business, leisure, and entertainment hub in Cambodia.
They immediately step out and start trading jabs. Yabo's looking nice and smooth, nice and relaxed in there. And Khan is just pushing forward, backing Yabo up a little bit here, getting him up against the cage.
Much the taller man, Khan, and you can see that difference as they stand center cage.
Yeah, Khan is hoping to close this distance, stay away from the kicks of Yabo, really utilize that clinch that he does so well and deliver some devastating knees.
Almost exposed himself by missing with that kick and then turning around, exposing his back to Amir Khan, but he managed to swivel quickly enough.
This is definitely where, see, now he's trying to get that clinch, but Yabo presses Khan up against the cage.
Yeah, some great use of each low center of gravity there, Yabo. Exchange the rigging knees to the ribcage.
There's those knees coming from that clinch, Steve.
We can hardly hear ourselves think here at cage side. A minute and a quarter into this opening round. The crowd here right behind Amir Khan were making a lot of noise there as those knees were being exchanged.
Yabo wants to utilize the space because he doesn't want to get too close because that clinch is so dangerous. He can keep the distance, utilize those kicks. He can start to put together some offense here.
Well, for the shorter man, he really does have a good jab. It connects nice and solidly with Amir Khan's chin. First, second of the fight, he managed that, and he just did it again. Oh, good left hand from Amir Khan.
I like how he caught the kick there, Steve, and then counter with that left hook. Khan coming in for the double unders now, pressing him up against the cage. Yabo's got to try to squeeze that arm in there. There you go. Khan defends well.
See Amir Khan just stomp on the foot of his opponent there. Every little thing you can manage to do to distract or hurt. And those contribute to a much bigger thing.
Those foot stomps can really do some damage too.
Sure
there's a lot
can.
Of little tiny bones inside there in the foot, and you can really slow down your opponent by utilizing foot stomps.
Metatarsal injuries that can often be soccer injuries. Made from the cleat or the stud of a football boot. Very similar effect here in mixed martial arts.
You can see Khan's utilizing that game plan of the clinch, pressing Yabo against the cage. Now this doesn't look like much, but it's actually very taxing.
Oh.
Usually Shimada wants to see more action. Yabo lost his balance a little bit there. Wasn't necessarily the blow that set him off.
Yeah, agreed.
Khan got caught as he came in.
Went for the spinning back kick, landed a left hand, and then got caught in the melee. Very quick hands Yabo has. He sees an opportunity in a moment.
Khan gets in for the takedown. Now he's in Yabo's half guard. Let's see what kind of ground game both these individuals have. They're both known for their stand-up abilities. Let's see what they're like off their back and on the top position. You can see Khan trying to push away, maybe looking to drop some elbows. Yep.
Certainly went with the elbow there, didn't he? The fist, the forearm, and the elbows, all dangerous weapons for the man on top here. But Yabo doing the sensible thing, bringing his man in close so he doesn't get that leverage to execute.
See, Steve, that's just like a defensive move. It's not really, you can't really do anything from there. All you're doing is stalling and hoping the referee stands you up. You can see he's flat on his back, and that shows just an inexperience. You really have to turn onto your side so that you can start pushing away easily. Time slides in the mouth. This is a bad position for Yabo to be in.
Listen to the crowd as the ground and pound comes down. Punches from the side of the head. The forearms are protecting the front of the head, but all of those punches seem to be getting through. And it's finished. Yuji Shimada steps in, and the sheer racket here in the Singapore Indoor Stadium will be enough to tell you that Amir Khan has won this fight via stoppage.
You could clearly see the inexperience of Yabo. Once Khan put him on his back, he really didn't know what to do. Khan easily slid over into the full mount position and then just unleashed a barrage of punches that eventually stopped the fight.
There goes the Stetson, his signature headwear. Eddie up there congratulating him. He sits it in his corner as well. And it's another win for Amir Khan. 21 years old, improves his record to 4-2. Take us through this, Mitch.
Here we go. You see that clinch, that strong clinch position where he's dropping the knees, throwing the elbows from the clinch. Here you can see the attempt on the spinning back kick. He actually got caught with a left hook and dropped him, but he manages to secure the takedown and end up in sort of a weird inverted position. But this is the position where he gets full mount, and it's just a moment in time before Yuji Shimada jumps in, stops the contest, and awards Amir Khan his next victory.
Here's Anthony Suntai with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the prize to the winner, we have the country division head, head of South Asia of Berocca, Ludovic Rossat. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this battle at 4 minutes 18 seconds of round number one. For your winner, via tap out, Amir Khan!
Amir Khan. Leading with that left hand.
You can see John Chang is very slick, he's very wide stance in his striking style. Amir Khan's also gotten a wide style, and he immediately goes in for the clinch there and trying to neutralize that striking capability of John Chang. It's kind of weird to call him John Chang. He's changed his name and a little bit more westernized in the name. He's clinched up there against Amir Khan. Both of them have the over-under. It's kind of a 50-50 position. Both of them have their hands locked, and there's, as you can see, Amir Khan's trying to slide that arm in underneath John Chang. He goes back to the over-under now. You know, John Chang says, you know, we spoke at length, you know, this week, and he says that, you know, he has a dark shadow that's over him with, you know, the fights that he's had with involved mixed martial arts, and he's hoping to get rid of it and start fresh and start new. Here he's working the guard, you know, pretty well. Attempted a possible armbar there. Amir Khan's trying to play with the feet a little bit. Passes over. You know, John Chang took a break from mixed martial arts and kind of focused only on kickboxing. So it'll be interesting to see what his ground game is like, because I don't know how much he's been doing.
Look at this unorthodox position for a while there.
Amir Khan was standing up, leaning over his man, but at quite a distance. What position is that? That's
Amir Khan was actually in the top position, and John Chang actually was going for a sweep. It's a very basic sweep in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu where you hook the feet and kind of use your legs to do it. And the funny thing is, Steve, I don't know if you know, that's a possible heel hook or knee bar, but his knee's a little bit higher in his hip, so he's kind of just holding on to it. He should really let go and realize that he did a possible heel hook. Could be cranking on the heel a certain way, but Amir Khan's doing the right thing by pushing the foot into his rear end to try to get some space. John Chang should kind of let that go there. There's a heel hook. He's trying to turn the heel the other way, but it's a little too hot.
Yeah, you know, Amir Khan managed to slip out of that and using his left hand to change the fight over. Just listen to the noise behind us. We've got a full house here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. 12,000 fans. I'm just looking around. I can't see an empty seat in the house, and they'll all be behind the Singaporean.
You know, John Chang's proving me wrong. You know, he's actually attempting submissions, and he's going after different things on the ground. You can see his movement off of his back is pretty good, but he just gets mounted, and Amir Khan just starts dropping bombs on him. This is not a good place for Chang to be in. He's got to cover up. He's got to start moving. You see how he's trying to get his feet up into the armpits?
Well, he is at least able to cover up. Both of his arms are fairly free. He's blocking a lot of those punches that are coming in.
Steve, I'm having deja vu because this is the exact same technique that he tried to do to me like 6 years ago, and it's not really going to work. It's possible, but not when you have... See how high he is in the armpits there of Chang, and Amir Khan's just dropping those punches down. Chang's got to plant his feet and move. He's got to move. You know, he's getting stuck in, you know, he's given a possible arm bar. And, you know, I don't think Chang's going to submit to an arm bar.
He's not throwing
that.
Any punches back, Chang. Yeah. Elbows and forearms coming down now. He's very, very busy, Amir Khan. He looks so strong, doesn't he? Stronger physically than I've ever seen him before. Looks as if he's really developed physically in the last year or so. Olivier Coste has seen quite enough. Thank you.
Good win for Amir Khan there. Got on top, got that mount position, and that was just the end for Chang as he just couldn't stop the onslaught of punches being rained down by Amir Khan. Big win for Amir Khan as he's moving forward in this new division for him. He kind of went up in a weight, so he's happy at lightweight.
And
he's
you can tell,
up.
I mean, he looks stronger. Yeah, he looks buffer. He looks really, really strong and athletic.
Yeah, he's a big guy right now. He's doing lots of weightlifting, lots of power lifting. He likes the evolution that he's seeing in him. And a good win for Amir Khan.
Improves his record to 5-2. That's 5-1 in the ONE Championship cage. Amir Khan has been taking incremental steps in his own personal development, and this is another very important part of his ascent. And he'll be donning that Singapore flag as the official.
To present the prize for this fight, we have Mr. Yunshul Park, Managing Director of LG Electronics, Singapore. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a hold to this bout. 3 minutes, 39 seconds of round number one. For your winner, via referee stoppage due to strikes, Amir Khan!
Fight! And they race towards each other at the start of this contest.
Fingers.
Amir Khan in the black shorts, Donaire in the red to the left of your screen as he circles to his left.
Amir Khan looks to keep this fight on his feet and showcase those stand-up skills, while Donaire looks to be the wants to get this fight to the ground as quickly as possible because Khan does have a significant striking advantage.
This fight brought to you by Alienware, 20 years of gaming excellence. Good left hand by Donaire.
Donaire does look light on his feet, though, and he was actually able to bring the fight to the former champion in his last fight when he fought Honorio Bonario.
Just looking to flick out that left jab, Amir Khan, and follow it up with a right hand. They were all pretty much short of the target, though. He's good on his feet, Donaire, and get out of range, as you can see there. He can back off at speed. What can he do when he's in range, though?
Donaire has told me time and time again that we have yet to see him really bring his best foot forward. And he believes all the things have aligned in his personal life, so he is completely ready for this fight here tonight.
He's made that transition from the Philippines to the UAE to focus on his career full time and make a real go of this in the twilight years, really, of his mixed martial arts life.
Twilight, I don't know about that, Steve, but you know, you can see definitely a little bit of salt and pepper up there on the head, but
37 years old, he says he wants to go to 40 plus. He's got 3 years to make what he can.
Good takedown defense by Amir Khan there. Denari trying for that outside trip, possibly looking to spin around. Amir Khan has been spending a lot of time with the strength and conditioning area of mixed martial arts, really adding a lot of big lifts, and he says that's gonna be the difference maker in this fight. Nice overhand right thrown by Khan.
Oh, he took a couple of good solid punches though from Donaire, a left and a right. Flush on the chin. And Donaire goes for it again and lands with a forearm this time.
And Khan takes down the BJJ champ. Scored well there on the takedown. Let's see what Denaire is like off his back now. Throws the legs aside, nice little transition into the turtle. Standing back up.
Knees to the head from Amir Khan. He's got control of that head. Keeping his legs out of distance so that Denaire can't grab them. Lefts and rights from the Filipino.
Denaire answers right back with some strikes. Good takedown defense, but Khan's got his hands locked.
Another successful takedown, and just listen to the reception from the crowd here.
Knee's okay.
What a big feather in his cap, because I'm kind of surprised here that Amir Khan's taken down. Oh, he goes for the guillotine. That could be deep, Steve. He lets it go, transitions around, spins around, takes the back in a beautiful transition.
He's got that right arm around the throat. Is it underneath the chin?
What a feather in that cowboy hat would it be?
He's got hold of the other arm. We're just waiting for the tap. Doesn't look as if he can get out of it. It's not underneath the chin. It's just on the chin. So that could crank that face in and cause just as much pain.
Look how relaxed Denaire is. He doesn't really, because it's not really threatened under his chin. It goes to the body triangle with the legs. Now he's just kind of locked himself into that position.
Has another go.
Now, now this one looks a bit higher.
The chin down.
1 minute into the first round.
Yep. Now he looks like that choke is a bit closer, but he's still got his chin tucked pretty tight.
Yeah, he's tucking it right down on his chest to prevent that forearm from getting around the throat.
There may not be a choke there, but there is a neck crank. You can put the chin into a very precarious position and start to crank on that neck. That body lock also that Khan's got wrapped around there is going to restrict the breathing of Denaire.
Very little that Denaire can do while that figure four is in place. Tries again with the crank move. He's keeping his chin down in a very disciplined manner. 20 seconds left, Amir Khan. Running out of time to do anything significant, but clearly this will score well in terms of the judges' scorecards.
Good defense from Denaire to fight off three choke attempts there from Khan.
Oh, it's under there, but the
yeah, see, but Denaire's holding that hand, though, so he can't really, he's doing a good job of defending there.
Well, Vaughn Donaire just looked up at the referee and gave him a smile there as we came to the end of that round. I think he was quite happy to see the end of it.
Yeah, really effective round from Khan. We see the takedown here where he just blasted right through into a double leg takedown, was able to get into the half guard of Denaire, and then just started working the ground and pound. Here he is, locking both hands, sending Denaire to the mat. And this is just where he was really able to control it. Rich, how do you have that round?
Well, you know, this was a really close fight on the feet. Each guy was landing the occasional punch or two. Obviously, this round is all about the ground control. What I really like about Khan's performance here is that once he hits the ground, he's already working from the takedown to the half guard, passing the half guard to the side control, and taking the back. Like, he's advancing his position and looking for ways to finish the fight. Obviously, not able to secure the rear naked choke from the back mount, but clearly has control so far up to this point in the fight, so he would win the decision at this point.
Well, don't forget, we judge our fights in their entirety, not round by round. Another 10 minutes to go, 5 minutes down.
Khan starting to move around nice and light on his feet as Denaire marches forward.
Filipino with that nice high guard.
Good takedown defense from Denaire. Able to stay on his feet that time, ward off the tank top. Again, Khan goes in, shoots in for the takedown. I think he sees something there on the ground he wants to exploit because he keeps pushing to take this area into what many would consider Denaire's strength.
Well, as he gets older, he's going to be increasingly more comfortable on the ground, Amir Khan, because of the people he trains with at Evolve MMA, world champion jiu-jitsu exponents. Every time we see him, you can expect him to be more and more comfortable on the deck. And that could be why we see him shooting so often.
And that is the beauty of our sport, MMA. Nice again, good takedown defense. He's got to keep those legs nice and wide. He doesn't want to let Khan. Oh, Denaire might be jumping for a guillotine. Decides better of it, shakes it off.
Two world title fights to come after this one.
Denaire is really aggressive in his striking. Loves to throw those hands with some serious heat as he throws the kick. Nice little transition from Khan to take the back and drag the fight to the ground to end up in side control. Easily steps over into mount and to triangle the legs like that. That was a pretty little transition, Steve.
Well, Denaire's given up his back and we may see another rear naked choke attempt here, but again, he was keeping his chin close to his chest, but now he's got control of the arms.
See, but when you have that hand under his armpit like that, it's easy to just kind of relax and not really worry about the threat of the submission.
Right.
But you can see the way Khan is holding down that left hand there, just so he can try to work that in there a bit more. But those long legs are able to body triangle and keep Denaire in there and prevent him from spinning into his guard.
Again, that figure four around the body, you're saying that actually just makes it difficult to breathe in these circumstances.
It constricts everything, makes everything real tight. Nice transitions to scramble up from Denaire. Look at the balance of Khan, though.
Did so well, fighting on one leg there for a few seconds and managed to keep his composure and his balance. 2:25 left in the second round, and they're swinging and missing in Donaire's case there. And fatigue starts to set in, apparently.
I was just going to comment how good Donaire's conditioning is for taking this fight on 2 weeks' notice. And again, but then he looked a little bit fatigued right there as we approach the second minute. But we only got 2 minutes left of the second round.
Let's not discount that. It's good of you to remind us to take a fight at 2 weeks' notice. Never easy, even if you are constantly in good shape.
And also that body triangle that Khan's been doing is going to slowly suck the energy out of Denaire. Again, Khan's able to try to step over into mount. Denaire does a good job to bring this fight back down to where he's on top.
90 seconds left of the second round.
Oh, good. I like how he applied the pressure of that chin to turn Khan's head the wrong way as he's trying to step over into full mount. He looks like he's going for a Kimura here. He's trying to step over. He's got side control. That's a deep Kimura. That's a painful shoulder lock, Steve, but he's got to try to get the arm a little bit further away. If he's got flexible shoulders, Khan can fight this off.
The crowd recognizes the seriousness of this. Watch for Amir's right arm. Is he going to tap? It looks very, very dangerous.
The human arm is not supposed to bend that way. Look at it. It's deep. It's deep, Steve.
Tremendous resilience from Amir Khan. Can he hold off? He's got 50 seconds. That's a terribly long time. Listen to this crowd willing on their man.
He could transition to an armbar here. What kind of flexibility does Khan have in that shoulder?
Barely hear myself think the noise this crowd is making. And Amir Khan pulls through and everyone around me is on their feet cheering their man on because he just came back from a very, very serious situation.
He seemed okay. He was pretty relaxed and pretty composed. No grimacing on the face. And now he's starting to drop some elbows from side control.
The worm has turned, elbows to the face, and suddenly Amir Khan to the fore once more. What a round!
What grit to fight off not only the Kimura, but then also to work your way out of the armbar as well. What a tremendous second round from both fighters.
What resilience from this Singaporean. And because this crowd in Singapore is so knowledgeable, they've seen so many first-class one championship nights. They knew exactly what was going on.
Look at this. He was able, I mean, the arm was a little, it really has to try to extend out to a 90-degree angle to where he can really start to crank on that shoulder. But then he transitioned into the arm bar. And Khan was able to do the right thing. Donaire was like, oh, I'm going to transition out of it. Made a slight mistake, and Khan was able to get back up. Rich, what do you got?
I'll tell you, this fight right now has gotten so close. Amir Khan was definitely in control of this fight, but I'll tell you, I can tell he's fatigued too. He does, his takedowns don't have the same pop. The aggression level these two guys have gone up. Obviously, Amir has controlled the ground most of the fight, but Vaughn is the only person to score in a near finish or a near submission category, which is our highest scoring category. I don't think it's enough to offset the ground control of Amir Khan at this point in time. So if the fight was stopped at this point, I would still give the decision to Amir.
Well, if you're enjoying this, don't forget our event in Manila on December the 2nd. Two world title fights there, just as there are later this evening for you. But we're enjoying this one right now. We don't need to look too far ahead, do we? Not with these two fighting with the determination that they are.
1 more minute, let's go.
Both fighters are looking exhausted, because you got to remember, Donaire took this fight on 2 weeks notice, but Khan is a full-time military man, so he's trying to juggle training between the military and his national service here in Singapore. So both these fighters are looking quite fatigued as we are approaching the third and pivotal round of this fight.
And when you try to pull off those kimuras and those arm bars, there's an awful lot of energy expended, so you can expect to see Donaire look as fatigued as he has at times.
But here, if he can get his breath, relax, and that's where that experience comes in, and he can try to get a little bit more, start moving those hips, possibly threaten with a triangle or an arm bar, and Vaughn's been known to do it before.
Oh, those hammer blows from his back, giving Amir Khan a world of trouble, and they just keep coming. Off your back, can you generate enough power to damage a fighter to prevent his forward momentum, Mitch?
You can. You can really strike from a lot of different areas, and especially with those elbows, if your opponent gives you that space to create, you can really start to do a lot of damage. Let's see, oh, but he easily passes the half guard and into full mount. This is a bad position for Donaire to be in. That arm slight might be under the chin, but Donaire's possessed really good submission defense. You know, he's been able to keep the chin down. See how he controls that? He's letting his, you know, Khan's got to let go of that arm. Maybe use his leg to lace it or shove that leg in there. So it's doing it. Now he's deep under the chin. He's gone palm to palm on the rear naked choke, Steve. But Donaire's got the chin down, doing the right thing, yeah, defending wise.
His defense on the rear naked choke has been first
class. That's what I was talking about, Steve. He used that leg to lace it, to lock down Vaughn's left arm. Uh-oh,
he's tapped.
That's it.
Yeah, I actually think he tapped twice. It was a very subtle tap, but a tap nonetheless.
I think it was fatigue. Beautiful, Steve. Beautiful submission.
2 weeks' notice, don't forget, for Vaughn Donaire. And that is a brave man to go so deep into this contest against a very skilled and capable mixed martial artist. Full credit to the Filipino, but the bigger credit goes to the Singaporean in front of his home fans. Winner by rear naked choke. There's the tap. Rich Franklin, we've got a Fight of the Night award brought to you by Marvel Studios' Doctor Strange in cinemas now. That's got to be a candidate.
Oh, I'll tell you what, this so far tonight has my vote, especially considering what kind of trouble Amir was in that second round. I've been caught in a submission like that. It's not easy to get out of. And for him to come back and actually win by submission, amazing.
So much more to come. Here's the decision with Dom Lau.
Presenting the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Chu Chi Wei, Vice President of Asia Emerging Market Group. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, put a stop to the fight after 2 minutes and 22 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of rear naked choke, Amir Khan!
Khan wearing the black trunks and he comes out very forcefully.
Immediately, Khan comes in, closes the difference, almost forgot about the hand touch, and immediately went to work. He's attacking that inside leg. He says he's not sure what he plans on doing in this contest. He's just gonna let it flow and just see what comes out.
Stands nice and side on, doesn't he? Switches stance as well, as you can see there. Open hands. Perfect kind of stance for mixed martial arts, isn't it? Left jab picked off Rajinder Singh Mina very skillfully there.
Attempting to close the distance, stay nice and tight. I like how he's switching back and forth between stances. Nice and upright though for Khan as he ducks under there.
Yeah, still filled with the pyrotechnics. Oh, that's a nice kick, although it was caught by Rajinder.
Yeah, but most of it was caught by his head. As Khan begins to go to work, Mina's got to move.
Big roar from the crowd here in Singapore.
Mina answers back with a big right hand, but Forrest Effort gets taken down to the mat. Now he's got Khan on top of him. Content to stay in half guard. Not even his, that leg's not even doing anything. He can easily slide over into mount, but he just chooses to sit there and ground and pound. Mina's got to move.
Elbows as well as fists, and it's over. Yuji Shimada has seen quite enough. Thank you. And to the rapturous roaring of the crowd here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium, Amir Khan clocks up his seventh career victory. And he gives the side post a bit of a kick there, tosses his mouth guard to Eddie Ng, and that was a very, very triumphant victory. Look at the way he landed that jab there and then got out of range as Rajinder swung that left hand at him. Knees to the head coming up there. Ingo the forearms as well. His man with his back to the cage, swinging in left and right, evading the big arm punches from the Indian. And with some blood there dripping onto the canvas, it was just about the right time that Yuji Shimada stepped in to call it a day. And it's another notch in the win column for Singapore's Amir Khan. Here's Dominic Lau with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee Yuji Shimada has put a stop to this fight after 1 minute and 29 seconds in the first round. For your winner by way of tap out, Amir Khan!
Go!
Jartim has been honing his kickboxing, says that Khan leaves himself exposed. Amir Khan says Jaroslav is open to right crosses to the chest and solar plexus, followed by left hooks. Jartim says second round, ground and pound, TKO. Southpaw stance on 22-year-old Singaporean Amir Khan. Switching stance now to orthodox, threads that left hand nicely, and back to southpaw. High kick from Amir Khan. He's lengthy, he's precise, and he's fast. And he just nails Jartim with that left out of southpaw. Locks up the leg, can he hope for a driving takedown, gets it on the check. Somersault backwards there from Jartim. Front headlock here from Amir Khan. Drives the knees in. Nice work from the Singaporean, and they're back to their feet.
Our team defends with a wizard there, but look at Khan's strength. Just got that body lock, now he's trying to muscle him back to the ground, but good work for our team. He's spin him around, but Khan gets control again because he has that underhook on the right side.
Yep. 8 week training camp for Amir Khan. 3 month camp for Jaroslav Jartim.
Hey.
Amir's corner telling him to keep the pressure on. Let's see if Jartim can exercise some of that speed that he said he'd need to beat Amir. And Amir beats him with a punch with a beautiful straight left down the tube. Takedown there from Amir Khan, doing everything right so far. Goes to side control. We'll look for a knee on belly here. Jartim looks to control the posture of the Singaporean. Where does Jartim need to go from here, Mitch?
He's got to move over onto his left side. He can't stay flat on his back like that. Khan's just got too much strength, too much pressure. But a big bridge by Jartim. But it doesn't allow him to change the position. It gets into actually a worse position here by giving up his back. Now Khan's working on both sides to get those hooks in. If he slides that left leg in, Jartim's going to be in a lot of trouble.
Amir Khan, 100% finishing rate. Only one has come via submission. 6 by knockout. He's hoping to sub out Jaroslav Jartim right now. Still has the back of Jartim. Jartim trying to find a way to his feet. Not a predicament that the Czech wants to be in.
No gloves.
Trying to wrap the arm around the neck of Jartim. Showing a lot of patience here.
Half time.
Very methodical, Amir Khan. 2:15 remains in the first round. Fight. Both men swing with the hooks, neither connects. There's the shot to the chest that Amir Khan said that Jartim was open to. Southpaw now from Amir Khan. Jartim's got to beat Amir to the punch, to the kick. Two very big athletes in this division. Has the back standing now, does Amir Khan. Little back elbow just to let Amir know that he's here from Jaroslav Jartim.
You can see Khan is just one step ahead of him in every single one of these exchanges.
Whether it's
a grappling exchange or a clinch exchange, Khan's just moving a little bit faster. Now he's trying to change levels, but he separates out. Expect that left hand to come again.
That was nice work from Jartim. You saw Amir Khan drop levels to look for a double leg, and Jartim underhooked him, stood him back up.
Left hand is landing over and over again. Oh, and he faces it. Oh, there he is. Come on. Oh,
he's got it. Amir Khan's done it. Smack bang. 100% finishing rate intact. Another first round finish for the stunning Amir Khan.
What a beautiful setup. He hit him again with the straight left hand through the high kick and then answered with a nice little right hook to put Jartim down. Beautiful finish. Let's take a look at that again. Boom, landed with the head kick. Boom, there's the right hand. Drops Jartim. Beautiful combination from the Singaporean Khan.
Amir Khan predicted a first round finish yesterday. He said the right hand would be one of the weapons it used, and certainly it's the one that did the job to finish Jaroslav Jartim. Let's go to Dominic Lau and make this knockout all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Fan Jianling, General Manager of Shanghai Just Sports Development Group. And now, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 46 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Amir Khan!
Judge, ready, go!
Here we go, first round. Side kick to the thigh early on from Amir Khan, then a high front kick. He's fighting in southpaw stance. High kick again from Amir Khan. Those headache makers are what Pang has to be careful of, Mitch.
Yeah. Khan needs to use all of his weapons. He can't get sucked into a brawl. Pang wants to go toe-to-toe, stand in the pocket, and throw heavy leather. Khan needs to use all the weapons, the jab, the punches, the push kicks, attack the legs, the body, and the head.
The hunter needs to find a way to get inside the massive reach difference here. You know that Khan wants to keep him at the end of his jabs. Keep him at the end of his kicks. But Pang has that explosiveness. At the moment, Amir Khan's doing a good job of controlling center cage. Another cutting kick for that lead quadricep. Pang setting the right hand. He goes for it. A momentary snifter on the inside. You can see the Thai Sakyan tattoo on the back there of Adrian Pang. Amir Khan, more kick than a chorus line so far here in the first.
He's really attacking that lead up, that lead leg of Pang really well. He's stomping on it, he's attacking it from different angles.
High kick there from Amir Khan. We've seen him knock out so many opponents with that rear leg roundhouse. And another skip up side kick to the thigh.
He's keeping that distance really well. He's just out of the punching range of Peng, but he does have to close it if he wants to punch, and that's where Peng is the most dangerous.
It's clever stuff so far from Amir Khan to go to Peng. He can't box.
In 42 matches, Peng has never been stopped. That's so scary when you think about it, because he knows his chin is iron. He can move forward with no fear.
Peng with the double underhooks here, looking for a takedown of Amir Khan.
You gotta think he's gonna have the advantage. He's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. You rarely get to see him use it. If this does go to the ground, he's gonna have a clear advantage over Khan.
Corking knee from the Australian, throws the elbow. Khan turns to me as the cage, can he get the knees off as if he's only here, Singaporean. Good switch up knee off the left leg there from Amir Khan. And that breaks off. There's the side kick again to the lead fire from Khan. I believe that's something they can expose on Adrian Peng.
And Peng sticks him with a stiff jab.
Khan switching stance now. Cuts the side kick again to the thigh. Peng's gloves up high. Side kick to the midsection. Peng fakes the right hand. Khan kicks in the bank, those long legs. The Singaporean beanpole drifts off to his right. Outside leaking from Peng, didn't find the target. Khan edges forward. You never know what Amir Khan's gonna throw next. He comes from awkward angle. Very unorthodox in his striking, particularly in his kicks. And that, Mitch, is what makes him so dangerous.
He's moving really well, interchanging the southpaw with the orthodox stance. And I like the way he's taking that lead leg of Peng out. Now Peng's got him up against the cage. This is gonna tell a lot. Is Khan gonna be able to reverse him like he did earlier? Yes, he is. But Peng gets him right back around.
There's a chance for the knees there momentarily for Amir Khan. Peng on the inside, reversed against the cage again, the Australian. Knees now from Khan.
We know how strong Peng is, so that's going to say a lot about the wrestling of Khan. He's really worked on that element of his game.
Front kick to the midsection from Amir Khan. Cuts that side kick to the left thigh again. It's been his most potent weapon here in the opening stanza. The Singaporean oozing with confidence, switching stance here. Throws another side kick to the thigh.
You can see the damage starting to build up on that lead leg. You can watch Peng is very gingerly stepping forward, but he is still moving forward.
Short little hooks there from Peng. Good jab from Amir Khan. Peng shoots in looking for a takedown. Khan defends. High crotch lift didn't work for the Aussie.
You can see the big breaths taken by Peng. Although that clinching is really starting to drain on Peng.
17 years the elder Adrian Peng, but with the whole world's experience over Amir Khan, that's the end of the first round, Mitch.
Watching him walk back. Look at these kicks by Khan. That was his best weapon, and it's setting up his hands really well. Every time Peng tries to move forward, Khan has an answer for him. Peng tries to press him up against the cage. There's a lot of scoring there. Rich, what do you got?
I have this whole first round, obviously, in the striking superiority category. Khan's doing a good job of moving in and out, using that front push kick on the leg, frustrating Amir. And you, like you said, the damage is starting to add up. You can see that Adrian is just being a little bit flat there. He has to be careful, though, because Adrian has that ability, and you can see it where he landed a couple two-piece combinations coming in. And he has that knockout power and the ability to do that. Right now, I have Amir ahead on the scorecard, slightly edging this one out.
But is the damage to the leg going to affect his ability to generate that power?
I do believe so. It's going to continue adding up. At this point in time, I don't believe there's enough damage to actually affect Adrian's power and his punches yet. But if he continues letting this happen for the, you know, another part of this round or the full round, and it continues into deeper waters, then yes, it's going to be problematic for him.
This is the round Amir Khan predicted he would knock out Adrian Peng. Center will come with a cross. But as they switch stance up between Orthodox and Southpaw, he couldn't choose off which hand the KO cross would come.
Khan's got landing that kick so well to that lead leg of Peng. Peng's got to find an answer for it. He's got to create something to eliminate, because that leg is starting to swell up. And it's going to get harder and harder for him to push forward like he normally does.
Peng swings wildly with the right hand, hoping for the big tub thumper. And Khan trips back. Triple jab from the Singaporean, using that reach advantage. Peng swings in again, they clinch up, and Khan presses him against the cage. Reversal from Adrian Peng. Beautifully done from the Aussie. Chance for the knees off the right leg, perhaps. You can feel the crowd on the edge of their seats here in Singapore. The titillation about this one. They're just waiting for something big to happen. And Khan turns Peng around again and breaks off.
Good defense by Khan to get out of that clinch. Peng is so strong once he has you up against the cage.
You just know at any moment Amir Khan could launch a rear leg roundhouse kick, could launch a straight cross. He is spectacular. And Peng slowly edges forward, drops the hand. He's going to try and sucker Khan in to a brawl. But Khan's not going to fall for it. Wisely so, he dances out of the way. And that lead leg has taken more knocks than a front door. Peng goes high with a roundhouse kick.
Adding up. Nice takedown attempt there. Hard to take down. Look at that wizard defense by Peng, but he pops right back up.
Overhook on the right arm from Adrian Peng.
Beautifully timed. Did you see that, Michael? He created the separation and went high with the left high kick.
That was thrown in a phone booth. No room whatsoever, and still Amir Khan got the kick up to the jaw. There's a side kick to the thigh again. Peng trying to get inside the pocket. Khan ties him up now.
Half time.
Got the back, look for Peng to fight those hands, create a little bit of separation, and look to spin around.
Foot stomp there from Amir Khan. And staying very patient. Every predicament you could imagine, Adrian Peng has been in at some time in his very long career. High move from Amir Khan! And Peng does a quick count of his teeth. That side kick of Khan has been superb. Could Peng have anticipated it? Have we seen that side kick that many times from Khan before?
I think Khan has shown us more weapons in his arsenal. He's reaching deep into his bag of tricks, and he's starting to show us new weapons. Every single time he sets foot in the cage, he's almost a completely different athlete.
And now you see what the Hunter Peng is trying to do. He's trying to time an overhand right counter off the side kick of Amir Khan. Is the switch foot, though, is the switching stance of Amir Khan causing some headaches for Peng, or is he really seeing it all?
I'm sure he's seen it all, but just the timing that Khan is displaying here. He's switching stances repeatedly, so Peng can't quite get a read on it. I like how he's trying to change it up. He's pushing up against the cage, transitions into a high kick.
Peng almost got the takedown, pokes up on the right arm as Amir Khan. You can hear the oohs and the ahs of this sellout crowd here in Singapore.
1 minute left in the second round.
We've got ourselves a real tussle in this co-main event.
Forward on Khan. Now he's got him up against the cage. We've seen Khan spin around before. He gets the underhook on that left side. Yep, now he's gonna try to turn him around. Exactly that. Now he's got him up against the cage.
Amir Khan seemingly doing everything right tonight. The 23-year-old, two rounds down and one remaining.
the gas tank. That's what the third round is gonna be all about. Who has the energy? Look at that beautiful separation as he stepped back through the high kick. That's hard to do. Here's the takedown, going for the ride in Singapore. Puts him down in the center of the ground. Now he tries to pass, but good guard control. Rich, how do you see it?
Yeah, I'm pulling up the whole graphic here so you can see this. You know, both these guys are being aggressive in their own way. Adrian's a little more aggressive, but you can see that it's starting to make its way up the scoring categories. Amir is starting to land a bit more of the strikes, accumulate some damage and stuff like that. But Amir, he's got to be really careful because Adrian is the kind of athlete that can explode. And it just takes a couple punches and you being in the wrong place at the wrong time where you can get dropped. So he just needs to be careful in this third round. Otherwise, that's how Adrian can steal the match.
Your scorecard looks pretty close. Damage inflicted was the only category. So if in this third round, Pang is able to unload a lot of damage, he can possibly sway in his favor.
Absolutely. He would have to do some damage here, but he would definitely sway it in his favor.
Sellout crowd here in Singapore. About to see the third and final act of what has been a gripping action drama. Amir Khan's kicks to the lead leg of Pang have been fantastic. They've been effective. Can Pang get on the inside and do that? Land those massive meat hooks.
He needs more of that. He needs to make this a brawl. Stand in the pocket and throw. Right now, Khan is moving around too much, and he's been able to pick his shots. Pang's got to keep going with this type of style right here.
Pang dropping down. May hope for another takedown. He got one in the second round. It didn't last long on the ground. Beautiful turnaround against the cage again from Amir Khan. He's done it almost every time, Mitch.
Very good. But Pang gets, when he gets up tight to the, up against the cage, he likes to transition to the high crotch. That's his best takedown. That's the one where he sent Khan for the ride a couple of times. Look at the clinch. This is where Khan excels.
Muay Thai clinch momentarily from Adrian Pang. Khan a chance to work his own knees, but he breaks off. Now let's see him go for the kicking arsenal. He's dancing on the balls of his feet. The highest knockout percentage in all of one championship belongs to Amir Khan.
Is Khan going to continue with that knockout streak he's got going on? Or is Pang going to turn things around? Oh, look at Khan. Khan to clinch up. That's starting to get real dangerous territory. Pang gets that look in his eye. You can just see bad intentions oozing out of his hands.
3 minutes, 10 remaining. Third and final round. Khan presses Pang against the cage. Tries to get that left hand under. What's Pang looking to do here, Mitch?
He's got the overhook on one side, and he's trying to swim it on the other. So he's going to be looking to spin Khan around to get his back off of the cage.
It's been a very action, boss! Action!
You action! See it taking a toll on Pang's gas tank. Yuji Shimada does it for him, but again, Khan goes back to that stomping to the lead leg of Pang.
And measures that cross off the left hand as Khan. Pang waits him with the left hook.
He was pulling some crazy moves there, but Khan actually slowed him down, didn't expend everything. Adrian Pang demonstrating good reaction time there with that head movement. Now he's got him up against the cage. He's going to transition to the high crotch.
He's going to go for a high crotch lift.
Single.
Adrian Pang. Amir Khan defending the takedown attempt. And once again, Khan turns Pang against the fence.
Defense there by Khan. I thought he was going to get that high crotch. He transitioned into the single. Good cage control awareness by Khan.
Wrist control there from Khan. Muay Thai clinch perhaps from Pang coming up. Throws the knees, controls the head. And just like that, Amir Khan slips out of danger. 90 seconds remaining now. Long reach on the left hand there from Amir Khan. The head kick. He stumbled. He takes Adrian Pang.
Immediately, Pang takes it hit on the chin, marches forward, throws a combination of his own, but initiates the clinch. You can see Pang trying to look up at the clock.
You can see the damage on the face of Adrian Pang. One minute left in the left ribs from the ulti. Tenacity, an amazing display of martial arts striking from Amir Khan, and Khan turns Peng around.
Michael, are you surprised we got 40 seconds left in this contest?
I would love to see another two rounds, Mitch. I could watch these two guys all night.
30 seconds left.
What a match. At 23 years old, Khan is demonstrating the composure of a seasoned veteran. Look at the way Pang was consistently pushing forward and the way Khan was able to dictate where and when this match took place, control the action. There's that head movement of Pang. I didn't think he had it in him. He's still got dancing left to do, but a beautifully timed head kick. The striking superiority was the key. Rich, how did you have that one?
I think you just did my job for me, Mitch. not really sure I can add any more than that. Khan was controlling the distance the entire match there, landing punches, pot shots, staying out of the pocket, not taking any damage. You can see it adding up on Pang by the end of the fight. Obviously, the scorecard's in favor of Amir. He should have this match.
But watch a performance from Adrian Pang, 40 years old, and as he promised, he did land some heavy leather to the body and to the chin of Amir Khan, but the Singaporean too slick.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of the body turned down in the judges' scorecards, all three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the referee.
Some noise for the local favorite, Amir Khan. Khan, a knockout artist of the highest order. Look for him to loop the shin around the back of the Korean neck.
Good start by Khan. Immediately takes center cage, right at a leg kick, and a nice opening jab. Song Jong Lee dives on a leg, tries to suck it in. Let's see if Khan starts to sprawl out. He's got to let go of that leg. Good top pressure from Khan to end up on full guard of Song Jong Lee.
Inside the guard of the Korean now. Can he break guard and posture up here? Works some ground and pound. Amir Khan. Khan, no slouch on the ground, as Mitch Chilson saw earlier.
You can see Song Jong Lee trying to attack the arm bar right there. He's got the arm underneath the leg, but the arm looks to be passed on the elbow side and slams his way out of it.
Amir Khan gets free of the arm bar again from the South Korean. Almost a minute down in the opening round. Jabs from Amir Khan. Shares his name, of course, with a very famous boxer.
And they both got a really nice jab. Khan is peppering Song Jong Lee up. Song Jong Lee don't like that, as Khan comes right over the top of that right hand.
Stiff jabbing here from Amir Khan. Song Jong Lee sucks the chin, looks through the brow, as well he should against a kickboxer of this high order. Beautiful hook-to-jab combination from Amir Khan.
Not liking Song Jong Lee's head placement. He's kind of tilting off to the side, off to his right there, and that's opened up the whole left side of his face. And Amir Khan is just lighting it up.
Amir Khan in southpaw stance, now switches to orthodox to confound Song Jong Lee, switching power sides. There's the jab again from Amir Khan. Khan rushes in, tries for a little overhand right, gets to the clinch, tries to pull Amir Khan down into his guard, gets him there now, one foot on hips from the South Korean. And can Amir break free? Posture up here. You see Song Jong Lee just controlling Amir's left arm.
He's
trying to attack the arm there. He's got his guard up nice and high, but Amir Khan knows exactly what he's doing. So he's framing off, creating a little bit of space, protecting the arm, and then dropping the punches. You can already see the welt building up on the side of Song Jong Lee's face from those jabs and the right hand of Amir Khan.
Song Jong Lee said he'd get a submission leg lock first round. Amir Khan predicted first round finish by KO. At the moment, the better prediction position would be for Song Jong Lee. Now coming back to his feet. Song Jong Lee trying to wrap up that ankle like it's in a bear trap.
Song Jong Lee's got to be careful. When you go inverted, you cannot leave your head open like this. Committed to that leg, though. He's going after it. There's a heel hook.
This is what he spoke about. Is Amir in trouble here, Mitch?
Not really. He's got his foot on the hip, and his knee is just about to pass the groin. Song Jong Lee knows what he's doing. He's transitioned sides. He's looking for that inside heel hook there, but he can't quite get it. See, now that Amir Khan's leg is out like that, now Amir Khan's going to try to take the back, but Song Jong Lee's trying to roll.
Amir Khan, half a strike off the right hand. Still, you see Song Jong Lee going after that leg, now gives up, and Amir back to his feet. Singaporean crowd like the stand-up situation for Amir Khan. Oh, just the back of the jab. Here's the power. Here's the heavy artillery from Amir Khan. And Song Jong Lee's been stunned. He's wobbled down. Down the uppercut, and again, make it three in a row. The elbow, smack bang. Amir Khan turning on a show. Another stiff right hand, another elbow. And Lee does a quick count of his teeth.
Man, Song Jong Lee is just tucking his chin, not even looking at Khan, and just swinging wildly with the punches. But look at the patience and the composure of Amir Khan. Stepping back like a sniper, just pinpoint accuracy, letting his bombs fly. Very relaxed.
Beautiful cross there, beautiful hook. Another cross off the right hand from Khan, sticks the jab. Song Jong Lee taking more moves than a front door. And then Khan went for a jumping knee. Under 30 seconds remaining. A boxing clinic now from Amir Khan.
Song Jong Lee looks a little bit wobbled, and he's blocking a lot of punches with his face. And that's not recommended against Amir Khan.
Look at the roundhouse kick. It sends it back four paces. Here comes.
Striking area, but here's some of the leg attempts of Song Jong Lee. Very active in his submission game off of his back, sacrificing positions. There he is trying to go inverted and attack the leg and just getting unloaded on. Look at that jab of Amir Khan, barely missed with the right hand there, but then Khan unloads, realizing Song Jong Lee is still in it and not out. He steps back, waits a bit, picks him apart a little bit more. Good, relaxed composure from Amir Khan. But Song Jong Lee's pretty tough, man. I think he realizes what's at stake being in this massive, jam-packed arena and the opportunity that has presented himself. He doesn't want to let anything slip by him.
Sellout crowd inside the mighty Singapore Indoor Stadium. Another classic in the making for one championship, the world's largest martial arts organization. We're ready to rock and roll second round of three. Neither prediction coming true of a first round finish, but my word, the action turned on by Amir Khan in the final 45 seconds was phenomenal. Switch step roundhouse kick to open up for the Singaporean in the black trunks.
Expect Amir Khan to shift into a different gear in this round. He's got the conditioning. Song Jong Lee looks a little bit fatigued, looks a little bit tired. Khan looks very relaxed, very fresh.
Could we see a contender here for the Go Daddy knockout of the night? Khan still peppering with the jab, threading it well. Changes angles, beautiful dipping left hand, hoping for the liver of the Korean. Then goes back upstairs. Jab two kangaroo from Amir Khan.
I'd like to see Khan go up high with the right kick. You can see Song Jong Lee starting to drop his hands a little bit, especially in some of these wild exchanges.
The lead hand of Amir Khan tonight has been a thing of beauty. Trucking elbow. The knees now from the Muay Thai clinch. Sends a knee drops down, hoping that Khan will follow him. And Khan doesn't want any piece of that.
Song Jong Lee's putting himself in a bad position in a lot of these, like, sort of sacrifice, pulling guard type maneuvers that he's doing. Oh, nice left hook there from Song Jong Lee. And again, he pulls guard again, but now Khan's a little bit slippery, so he slid right off.
Don't forget, Amir Khan brought three Japanese wrestlers to Singapore to prepare for the takedown defense. And he's showing it well at the moment. Training has paid off. An extensive count for Amir Khan. But guts and intestinal fortitude here from Sung Jong Lee of South Korea.
Yeah, Michael, but he brought in takedown wrestlers, people that were trying to push him up against the cage and take him down. Sung Jong Lee is attempting some very interesting little scissor takedown there into a leg lock. He's got that good grip on that heel. Look at Khan trying to run away. Oh, he chooses to sit back down.
The first hammer fist there from Amir Khan.
Possible calf slicer here on that right leg of Khan. This is a painful position to be in right now.
All tied up like a demented game of Twister. Khan just glances over to his corner. What are they telling Khan to do here, man?
Look at that leg. That's just like, all right, trying to sit up out of this position. There's a full calf slicer on the right leg of Amir Khan. Very painful move. He's got to try to get his hips away and slide out. Song Jong Lee is crafty on the ground, man. Some of these submission attempts, that scissor takedown, woo, impressive. Now he's going after the heel hook. It looks like it's a straight leg lock.
Leg locks are the specialty of Song Jong Lee.
Achilles lock there, puts a lot of pressure on that Achilles there, right below the calf muscle.
Anakis strikes, elbows from top position, still the legs tied up of Amir Khan. 2 minutes remaining here in the second round. You know that Khan wants to find a way back to his feet, Mitch.
You can see Song Jong Lee's got the legs triangle. Now he's going for a cross-body ashigarani, maybe, from that position. That's what it looks like. Trying to extend the legs there. Going after the... Yep, that's where he's going after. Going after the heel hook on that side.
1 minute 40 now. Still Song Jong Lee playing the leg lock game. Looking for the Achilles, looking for the heel, looking for the knee.
Look at it. That's a heel hook right there. Look at Khan trying to roll. He's trying to get his leg out, and he does.
What a victory. Bringing back the aggression as he promised his camp, his management, and his fans. And certainly, Amir Khan delivered. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 39 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Amir Khan!
Ready, go!
It's one championship, Team Lakai versus Team Evolve MMA. And Amir Khan from Evolve bounced out of his corner. He predicted he would knock out Benario inside of 4 minutes or choke him out.
Watch that left hook of Benario as Amir Khan's closing that distance. Benario likes to throw that hook just as kind of a distance finder, but he tags him early in the round.
Benario with a wushu background. We'll expect the cutting side kick. He went for it there. Went for an outside link kick, Benario. Nice left hand from Benario. High left roundhouse kick from the Filipino. Both men high on the balls of their feet.
Amir Khan circling to the right. That's the power side of Benario.
Amir Khan with a fabulous ability to loop the shin around the back of opponents' necks. already 50 seconds down. Switching stance there, Amir Khan, and back to orthodox stance, threads out the left hand. Bumps up very high for Benario, goes to the jaw, goes to the body. There's a left roundhouse kick from the Filipino.
Like how Benario goes in for that left hand, he likes to create a little bit of distraction to the body, but then he comes up top, goes headhunting.
Amir Khan wants a crack at the world title. He's got to get through Benario here tonight. There's the sidekick again from the Filipino. There's the left roundhouse kick aimed for the neck of Benario. Both men trade roundhouses. Sidekick looking for the lead by there, Benario.
I know we got a big match coming up in Bangkok for Kaioken versus Tang for the number one contender, but this right here, this could be for the number two contender spot.
Driving takedown has Benario on his back. Top position inside of half guard. Look at the posture up now, Amir Khan. Can he get the ground and pound? Can he get a choke here?
Oh, good job by Benario to get back to his feet.
Benario free and clear, goes to the body, looking for the liver off the hands, then off the legs. Amir Khan throws out the left roundhouse kick. A Singaporean momentarily on the back foot. Now he comes forward. Adding side kick just above the knee for that common peroneal nerve from the Filipino.
So I know, Michael, this is Team Lakai versus Team Evolve, but there's also a little bit of extra motivation for Khan in this one. Benario had a three-round unanimous decision victory over Amir Khan's mentor and sensei, Eddie Ung. So there's a little bit of extra redemption on the line here for Amir Khan right now.
And here's the rear naked choke. One of his predictions, he said it would come inside of 4 minutes. This would be prophetic. It would be amazing if he could finish it by a rear naked choke.
Get those hands off his head. Look at him turning to the side there, trying to go chest to chest, but Khan's following him around.
Amir Khan said, I'll rear naked choke or knock him out inside of 4 minutes. He's going for the rear naked at the moment. Those turtle shells are Nerio Benario, the former world champion. Khan resets. This would be amazing if he somehow gazed into his crystal ball yesterday and called it. Can you believe it, too, if the knockout king, the man with the most knockouts in one history, gets a sub here tonight? That would be crazy.
I can't. Amir Khan's got a very underrated ground game. He is slick on the ground. Look at it. He's got to get into that chin, though. Look at Benario's doing a good job of fighting those hands.
Looks up towards the big screen to see how much time is remaining. He's defending, ties up the wrist. Couple of popping back fists there from Benario. 1 minute 10 remaining. First round, that's been a ripper.
Let's see Benario change sides, try to switch his body over to the other side, because as he's lying into this side of Khan, Khan's got a good grip on him. So if Benario can change positions and roll to the left side of Khan, he might be able to scramble out of this position.
Amir Khan in control on the ground, has the back of the former world champion Honorio Benario.
But he allows Khan to get both hooks in. Now Khan's trying to lace that hand over the leg and attack the neck again.
Can Khan split it?
Benario looks okay. He's trying to peel the hand off the top of his head. Khan's got a good
squeeze. Thank you, mother, for the rabbits. That's amazing. Amir Khan times out Benario as he said he would do with a rear naked choke. Can you believe it?
Calls his shot with the rear naked choke. It might not have been inside 4 minutes. We might have to check the clock on that one.
I reckon it was about 4.5, but either way, what a prophetic call from Amir Khan yesterday. Have a look at the way the Singaporean sinks the choke in here. This was just superb. Arm goes around the neck. Benario, no place to go. Lights are about to go out on the Filipino. And he taps out. Amir Khan, that was phenomenal. What a win for Evolve MMA. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Li Weiting, General Secretary of Shanghai Sports Association. And now,
Your referee, Mr. Kim Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 34 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Amir Khan!
The Kung Fu and BJJ stylings of Rahul Raju and the boxing here of Richard Corminal.
You said that Richard Corminal was a bit slow in his anticipation of where he's going to go next. So you can try to watch him try to exchange first and try to be first because he thinks Richard Corminal is a bit slow in that initiation of the strike. As you can see right there, he's getting off first.
Here is Rahul Raju. Nice two-punch combination from Corminal. Turning in the left hook. Drifts off to his left. Jab overhand right from Corminal. If it goes to ground, Corminal is... advantage, I'd say. It's a BJJ purple belt around the waist of Rahul Raju, which should have the advantage if it does go down, Mitch, for the Indian.
Yeah, you know, if he's very heavy top game wise, looks like he's doing a really good job of coming right down the middle of Richard Corminal's guard, and that's where he said he would have the advantage. He thinks he would have the advantage inside these exchanges because if you watch, Corminal kind of loads up before he throws shots, and that's why Rahul Raju is coming nice and straight down the center line.
Big opportunity for both these men, both coming off losses, so a desperate need to get back into the winner's circle. No better card to do it on than here in Singapore tonight.
Yeah, there's a lot of eyes on these guys, especially for Raju, who's in his hometown.
Rahul Raju has been launching the heavy artillery at the hands early on in the first round here, trying to force Corminal to the outside. Counter right hand down the tube there from the Filipino. Jab two from Corminal.
You can see Corminal's losing a little bit of power when he throws that straight right hand because he's picking up his back leg just ever so slightly. You really got to sit down on your punches if you want to add that little bit of extra zest to that big shot.
Two-punch combination down the center corridor. Third punch off the left there from Corminal. Fakes to the body, goes to the head. Got to defend that cut over the right eye of the Filipino. It's come early in this contest. Nice tuck under there of the right hook and a stiff jab through there from the Indian. That was nicely done by Raju.
Yeah, Corminal's got good head movement. You can see him trying to get out of the way, but he's got very exaggerated movements as he just paid a huge head kick. Corminal's rocked.
Corminal on rubber legs here already, not even halfway through the opening round. This is a superb performance from Raju. The striking of the Indian, the Kung Fu brown belt, has been on point so far.
Nice little combination there as he's putting his hands together and he's leading that head kick up. Corminal's got to keep his hands nice and high. You can see he's kind of punching from his waist there with these big wide open shots. And that's where, you know, Raju's able to come right down the middle. He's rocking him now. He's hitting the side of the head over and over in the temple. I don't know if Corminal's going to be able to get out of the first here.
Corminal blowing heavy already, 2 minutes, 10 remaining, still a long time to go. Jab to hook to uppercut there from Raju. Comes up a loss against the former world champion, Honorio Benario. By decision.
Yeah, both these guys have a common opponent in Gary Tonin. So this is a very intriguing matchup because they have, you know, similar styles and they're choosing to bang. I thought it was going to come down to the wrestling. But Rahul Raju said he wanted to bang it out on his feet and he's doing just that. He's definitely seen some openings inside the guard of Corminal. You can see how Corminal's dropping his hands and he's trying to move his head. But if Rahul Raju catches him with another one of those big shots, he could sleep Corminal. Corminal's wearing these punches pretty well, except for that damage over his right eye right there.
Body kick there from Raju. We will see Gary Tonin later on tonight's prelim show against Yoshiki Nakahara of Japan in a featherweight contest. That should be a ripper as Tonin looks to maintain his undefeated record.
See, Raju's been working on his boxing quite well. Ooh, a nice little jumping skip knee there to the overhand right leg. And he connected again as Rahul Raju goes down with turn of the tide.
Corminal's got a sniff now, tagged him flatly on the chin. It was a beauty, and now they go to ground. JJ experience of Raju will prove the difference here as he tries to pass to the right side of the body of the Filipino. Half guard position here, under 45 seconds remaining.
He's pinned down the crucifix there. Corminal's got to start moving a little bit. He's got to get the underhook on that left side with his left arm and create a little bit of movement. We knew it was going to come down to the wrestling here, and easily Raju cuts through that half guard. Now he's just raining it down. He's got to move. He wants the last 25 seconds here. Raju's sinking
it's about him to shoot in, get that single leg, put Corminal on his back, control that top, and then he started working a little bit of the ground and pound, came through the half guard, sat easily in the mount. Corminal gave up his back, and he was able to lock in a rear naked choke. That was a good performance from Rahul Raju as he celebrates here in front of his hometown. Check and see, it was a beautiful pass, and you can see he went after the choke first. He didn't even need the hooks in. That's how confident he was in his ground game, and it was just over the chin right there. So that's a pretty dangerous squeeze he's got there, Michael, as he just applied that pressure and forced the tap there from Corminal. Because look at this, he doesn't even get the rear naked choke in, Michael. So you can see how good of a squeeze Rahul Raju is, because he doesn't have it underneath the chin, he doesn't have both hooks in, then he goes into the hooks, get that little triangle right there, has that leg laced. There's no place for Richard Corminal to go except to tap his way back to Malaysia.
Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 43 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Rahul Raju!
Michael Chavallo, Mitch Chilson, Mitchell. India versus Pakistan. Both men in orthodox style. Mike throws away of Cheema. Look out for the right hand of Furqan Cheema. Will we see some of the kung fu stylings here from Rahul Raju? Furqan Cheema on short notice. Spinning back, gets under it as Raju. Back to the Pakistani against the right.
It's a dangerous move to attempt so early in the matchup. He gave the opportunity for Rahul Raju to get nice and tight into a body lock. He likes these types of takedown attempts. We're gonna see him possibly try to reap the leg, put him onto his backside. Good balance so far shown by Cheema.
Just up in the corner here. Overhooking that left arm from Furqan Cheema. Hooks the leg to Rahul Raju. Raju hunting for a takedown here in the Pakistani. Look at the question, was getting sandwiched there.
Good balance shown by Cheema to avoid the possible takedown from Rahul Raju. Rahul Raju might choose to change levels here and attack the legs. If the two fail the takedown attempts on the body lock, he might be able to suck the hips in, get nice and tight, turn the corner, and put Cheema on the backside.
We've seen the Indians really come on strongly in one championship in recent times. Big wins for the likes of Al Jambua, Gurdashan Manga, Ritu Thonga. Can Rahul Raju continue the trend for India in one championship here tonight against Furqan Cheema?
Good takedown defense from Cheema to avoid the body lock takedown from Rahul Raju. Now we get to try to see what this boxing's like with Cheema. We've heard a lot about it. He starts opponents in the past. If he can put hands on Rahul Raju.
And Furqan Cheema find a way to uncork that straight right drop. Close the jab. Raju taking his time. Very patient, the Indian. Press the Pakistani back.
Stones, remember stones.
Here's the right hand from Cheema. Raju saw it coming. Shoots in for a takedown attempt here with Raju. Cheema trying to defend. Raju locked onto that single. Where does Cheema go from here, Trey?
Got an underhook on that one side, but once you're able to lock the hands, get the hands underneath the rear end, you can suck the hips away and put you on your backside, and exactly what Rahul Raju did. This is what I said might be the difference maker in this match. It's the ground skills of Rahul Raju. He's a legit BJJ brown belt. Now he's in the guard of Cheema. Expecting him to try to push down on the legs, possibly trying to pass the guard of Cheema.
Close to the body here from Rahul Raju. Inside the close guard of Furqan Cheema. 150 remains, first round of three. The Indian looking to pass.
Cheema can't stay flat on his back like that. He's immediately got to start turning. It's not a good sign for Cheema. Once you get put on your back like that, and somebody starts to start passing your guard, you immediately have to turn to your side and start moving away. You can't stay flat on your back like that. Good job by Cheema, though, to work his way back up, but he gives up a single leg. Can't hold the ropes like that either. Might lose the position.
Big hello to all of our Indian viewers watching on Hotstar and Star Sports Select 2 in India. No doubt cheering on their man, Rahul Raju.
Oh, he's reaching into the back pocket. I think he's going to give it to him. Possible yellow card. You can't. He warned him once about possibly grabbing the ring ropes. And then he did it again pretty blatantly. And that forces Olivier Kos to issue a yellow card. Now, that is a 10% reduction in a athlete's purse. You can see, can't really see it from that angle right there, but with his left hand, he clearly grabbed the ropes. And that's what Olivier Kos issued the yellow card for.
Furqan needed the outside thigh here from Rahul Raju as we commence. First round of three. Raju having a very good opening round, trying for a ranging takedown. Nice lead in the midsection there from Furqan Cheema. Cheema undefeated as a pro, went 3-1 as an amateur. Also undefeated in boxing, Furqan Cheema. Hooking up that right arm over Raju.
He's got an overhook, trying to utilize a wizard, but he's going to have to drive a little bit more heavy into his shoulder. You can see just how high Rahul Raju is on the underhook on that side. That's going to give him good control and good position, especially if he chooses to lock his arms and then try to reap the leg and then go for the outside. He's going for an inside trip. Good balance shown by Cheema so far. Let's see if Rahul Raju can get this down in the last 26 seconds of this matchup in this round.
Tenderize that left leg. Raju even went for a foot stomp in the exchange. Still with the overhook on the right arm of Furqan Cheema of Pakistan. 10-second clock has sounds. We'll go to the towels and both men will get some much needed instructions. Cheema having words there, it looks like, with Rahul Raju. May he play some mind games with the Indian. One round down, two remaining. Don't forget to follow us across all your social media. On Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube at One Championship. Sold out inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Vitor Belfort amongst our many VIP guests here ringside in Singapore. Great to see Vitor, who of course is a part of the One Championship roster.
That was an interesting first round from both these guys. There wasn't a lot of action, not a lot of big shots thrown, but we were able to see some ground control and a little bit of dominance coming from Rahul Raju. He was able to secure a takedown, get on top, drop a little bit of ground and pound, but didn't do too much with it. Overall, we did get to see a little bit of takedown defense coming from Cheema. He was able to utilize balance, underhooks and overhooks just to sort of maintain and stop the advancement coming from Rahul Raju. I think we're gonna see a little bit more aggression coming from both these athletes in the second round, because especially with that yellow card given to Cheema, he's gonna have to send some urgency in this second round and really start to put things together, because he wants to show exactly what he can do here in One Championship.
Second round, India versus Pakistan. A good opening round for the Indian, Rahul Raju. And Cheema find the range with that right cross. Outside leg kick from the Pakistani. Close jab overhand right. Raju very composed so far. Good right hand to a single leg here from Raju. Gives up on that though. Can he get Cheema on his back? Hits the leg. Cheema being told not to hold on to the ropes. Yes, that is carded in the opening round for holding the ropes. And here's some left hand to the side of the hip from Rahul Raju. Back to the feet for Cheema.
Cheema has spent most of his career competing inside a circle, so it is a little bit different for him to be pressed up against the ring ropes like this and not sort of reach out and grab it. I don't think he's doing it maliciously. I just don't think he might not have as much experience inside a ring as Rahul Raju does, so these are just sort of reactionary tactics. They're not necessarily him trying to shoot or break the rules in the fashion.
Loaded up that outside thigh kick did Raju. A shin on top of the quadriceps of the Pakistani. Good two-punch combination there. The right hand just missed the target. The left hand scored.
You see Cheema's a little bit hesitant to really sort of throw that right hand, because he knows that Rahul Raju wants to get in nice and tight, look for another one of those takedowns. He might want to start throwing some uppercuts and knees just to get Rahul Raju thinking about that. Just like that.
As I said, the Indians coming on so strong in one championship. None more so than last week's superb debut by Ritu Folga over in Beijing. First round TKO victory for Ritu was phenomenal. Just then hit him off Korea. Could have done, put in a crucifix and it away. Certainly leading the Indian charge, along with Dirshan Manga, who will take on Christopher Collins soon. Also Arjun Bua, a good win in Tokyo. Against Mauro Cirilli. Raja, right hand, all leg here for the Indian. Takedown, nicely done from Rahul Raju.
That was a beautiful entry into that double leg. I like how he disguised it by throwing the hands first and then going for the double leg. Now he's on the back.
Get into it!
Choking.
This would be huge! This would be massive! Is he going to choke out the Pakistani? Yes! 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 It's a win for India! A win for India! A win for Rahul Raju!
That was a beautifully done rear naked choke. Timed it exceptionally well. Threw the hand combination, ducked under the retaliation, got the double leg, sucked in the double leg, immediately took the back, locked in that rear naked choke, didn't even need the hook. That's just how strong a squeeze that Rahul Raju's got. Locked in the choke, and that was a wrap. Look at this, beautifully done, got the double leg takedown. Once he secured the double leg, hands went behind the hips, sucked him away, put him on his backside. You can see he stepped over the guard, beautifully done. Once he had this position, he started with the right hand right up under the neck, applied the backhand, applied the squeeze, and got a huge win to keep the Indian train rolling, Michael Cervello.
They will be celebrating in Mumbai, in Delhi, in Goa, all across India tonight in celebration of Rahul Raju. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes in the second round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Rahul Raju.
Choke! It's finally happening. Amir Khan. See the little head shakes, the blinking, that's the Tourette syndrome. He's had all his life. Martial arts has helped him overcome the effects of Tourette's. Edging, the load up of the hands. Khan can load up of the hands and the legs. Ed's also got a wicked head kick on him. Thickly built Edging, built for speed and also power. Long, lean, Amir Khan. Switch up round kick there from Khan. Look how low the hands are on his chin.
A lot of different weapons thrown by Ting so far, just to see how Khan kind of reacts. Went to the body, went to the legs, mixing up a lot of the weapons. Now he's inside that clinch of Khan.
Khan turns him around. Now Ting turns him around. They're doing a tango in the corner. He'll get the upper hand in this exchange.
Run again.
Jousting for position early on this match. So much on the line, so much at stake. Chance to get back in the hunt for world title gold in 2020.
These guys looking for that opportunity to take on the lightweight king, Christian Lee. You know, Christian's backstage paying very close attention to this one.
Looping the hand there. A shoulder. From Amir Khan, looks for a takedown.
Nice little body lock transition to the back. Ting immediately pops back up. Khan doesn't let him off the hook. Immediately goes to the body lock. Let's see if he can finish this. Look, you can see Ting immediately starts battling those hands, trying to create that little bit of separation.
Separate now they do. Back to striking back. Edging, the Malaysian Kiwi, edging forward. Fakes there from Ting. Comes up high in Amir Khan. Khan looking in tremendous shape. And hand to lock. Spikes again. Goes back.
Arm troops up, get the clock round.
Touches being contained. Threatening a head kick.
Amir Khan should be focused in training on coming in a lot of armor. Not being so checked. Not overexerting and rushing. Short for 2 thirds round. Cheema going to have to muster behind it.
He's mixing up those weapons. He's threatened a lot so far. Giving Khan a lot of different looks.
Amir Khan launched that rear leg round kick.
He's been threatening a lot with that hip switch. He's kind of throwing that hip out there, seeing how Khan reacts. He hasn't called for it yet.
MT flexed the right hand. Arm on the outside here. He's getting hooked in. Arrow punch up, hanging ahead of the chin. Khan turns him around the corner. Tries to wrench into the canvas. But Ting stays on his feet.
Ting's looking very confident, carrying his hands very low, which is a dangerous situation considering the knockout power of Khan. But Ting doesn't seem to be scared about it. And he's got that overhook on the right side. That wizard is going to allow him to do a little bit of defense. But he throws it off, goes over the top, but he gives up his back in the process.
And breaks up. Actually striking now. Singapore Muay Thai champion, Amir Khan. Outside leg kick attempt by a chick. Some fakes and feints from Ting in the first round. And a sucker Khan in. And comes forward, two-punch combination. Exclamation mark for the high kick. A kick there from Ting.
1 minute left in the first round.
Four round across the throat there, from Khan. Ting drives into the corner. Arms with the knees back. He got put on though by Amir Khan. Chance going up at a section of the crowd for the Singaporean Amir Khan.
Ooh, that elbow, I think he's raised the nose right there. Did a little bit of damage to the bridge of the nose of Ting. Excellent elbow on the exit. This is where Khan's dangerous.
And Ting's been cut. Here comes Amir Khan. And it's opening him up in the first round. The crowd from Ting. Chad from Khan. Kid goes body and head. Kid comes forward outside fighting. This will give Khan confidence. Khan tries to take the back standing. Goes on his back. Final second of the opening round. And Khan has damaged their chin.
It was a very interesting round. A lot of different weapons thrown by Ting, but Khan was able to find a lot of holes in the guard of Ev Ting, especially once it was inside that clinch. It was a beautifully timed elbow on the exit out of the clinch that did the damage to the bridge of the nose of Ev Ting. It was beautiful, and I think that's gonna be a problem that they're addressing right now in the corner of Ev Ting. That's what Amir Khan needs to do more of. He needs to be a little bit more active inside those exchanges, because right now that was a beautifully timed elbow and it did a little bit of damage. Let's see how the second round starts to unfold.
On the one fantasy game, on the one super app, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, 58% of fans voting for Amir Khan to get the win. We are sold out inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. It's a glittering spectacle.
Right, ready?
The martial arts show shows one championship. Confidence oozing out of every pore of Amir Khan right now. He opened up the nose of Ev Ting in that opening round with an elbow.
Dangerous with those elbows, especially inside that clinch. He works with a lot of Muay Thai world champions out there of all mixed martial arts. And you know his clinch game is on point.
Elbow on the bit, lift. Then you knee behind. And lift your head. And lift your head.
Put
your head. Inside trip.
And chin spins him around. Chance for the elbows, maybe. But he's here from Khan. Drop down his weight to the Singaporean. Amir Khan, who is a great golfer. He has won that in golf. He's more time than mixed martial arts instead.
He's spent his childhood cracking balls, and now he's cracking heads.
Circles off, block wide. Goes the Singaporean Muay Thai champion. Team lines up the right hand. There we go! Finjong. Khan takes the back standing. In with the hope of Emily on the main of his corner tonight. There from Amir Khan. Opened up empty in the first round. See the result of that in the offensive kick. He comes forward. He has been moving well. I'm trying to cut off the movement of the Singaporean. Amir throws to the lead hand. Team goes for the headache maker. This is for it. That a small cut under the eye of Amir, or is that the result from team space?
I think that's just some scar tissue that he's had. I've seen in the past few matches, I just think it's maybe a little mouse that's just kind of developed over a long period of time. Have team calling him to the middle saying, let's dance, man.
Team goes to the body, then goes to the head. Left hand body, right hand head. The Kiwi Malaysia. And both the Malaysia and New Zealand flags. Run kick to the ribcage there from Ting.
He's doing a good job.
Ting Dragon.
Cutting out the corner. He's trying to, you know, corner Amir Khan, but Khan's doing a good job of circling away. He is circling into the power side of Ting, but Ting seems to hasn't really been an answer for it. Like to see him maybe throw that big head kick and try to piece up the legs of Amir Khan.
Khan turns in the corner. Ting turns him back. 2 minutes remaining. Second round of three. Very good first round for Amir Khan. Overhook of the right arm of Tim. Going for wrist control. They break off. Arm long and rangy. Tim built for speed and power. Natural movement here from Amir Khan. Jab to the body from Eb Ting.
And see Ting's just leaking from the right side of his face. Khan staying nice and composed, not getting too overly aggressive, but a beautiful takedown by Eb Ting to end up on top. Let's see if he can pay back some of the damage that Khan's done to him in the first.
Ting in top position. Can he break open the gap and bring down the ground and pound? He's got a heavy ground and pound if he unleashes here on Khan.
1 minute left, and the second
round. Khan controlling the Kiwi Malaysian's posture. Bound to his face. And Ting's face is a horror story. Jab there from Khan. Run kick from a Singaporean.
Dangerous way to get up for Khan, but Khan survived the necessary damage as he pops back up to his feet as that team marches forward.
Oh, he tagged it! Beautifully done from Amir Khan! And turns him against the rope. Hooks the leg, there's Ting. 30 seconds remaining.
Secure a takedown here. This would be huge at the end of the second. Choose to let it go. They're back to the center, dancing around, throwing hands again. You can see Tink's trying to pressure him into the corner, trying to corner him. Good circle of your movement. Going in from Khan to avoid getting cornered.
Tink trying for an X kick.
Dance again.
Runs out the hand, wants to engage with Khan, but Khan not getting sucked in. Team wants a body group, and Khan refuses it. One round to go.
Okay, let's take a look. This is what happened to Eb Ting. Watch the break. Watch how he postures down the elbow, and boom, comes right over the top. That's what crooked it up Eb Ting's nose, and then he just kept going after it. That cut was just a target, and Amir Khan started to light that up. The most significant portion of that match had got to come from the superficial damage on the face of Eb Ting, which is gonna score very heavily in the eyes of the judges. But now, we've got 5 minutes left, Michael Cervello. What would you like to see happen in these last five for both these high-level athletes?
Well, Eb Ting wants to engage in the phone booth, wants to turn it into a Donnybrook brawl. But Amir Khan so far has said no, keeping his distance till he finds the opening.
F-Team playing to the crowd, though they are firmly behind their own Amir Khan.
Ready?
Third and final round. Stop the bleeding on F-Team. Let's see if Khan tries to get it going again. King edging forward. He'd love to throw that overhand right or that looping hook. There's the hook. There's the hook again from Evchen. Backed against the ropes. Khan trying for the knees. And breaks out of danger. Khan wants the room to move. Ting wants to get on the inside. Contrasting styles. You see Ting says, come on, come here. Plant yourself. Let's go toe to toe. He's talking to Amir Khan. He's trying to bait Amir Khan.
Yeah, but Khan knows what he wants. Khan knows that F-Ting lives inside the firestorm, so he's going to consistently circle out and avoid that because right now he might be slightly ahead. I think he feels he is ahead on the scorecards, and he wants to avoid any risks. He just wants to keep touching, keep circling, keep moving. F-Ting needs to change things up. I like the strategy. Some psychological gamesmanship coming from Ting. But right now, he needs to do more than just that. He needs to create the action. He needs to problem solve right now.
Time is ticking down for F-Ting. 3:30 remains. The high kick. There's a nice counter. Look down from Khan.
Beautiful jab counter right there as Ting threw up the high kick. As soon as he put the foot down, Khan went in there with a nice stick. Hard jab.
I'm back to 3 sets. Going clockwise. Wild looping right hand there from F-Ting. A human highlight reel. Maybe getting frustrated a little here with the constant movement of Amir Khan. Khan drifting left, drifting right. Back off to his left now. And Ting goes off the movement of Khan. Cut off the ring. Round kick to the ribs there from F-Ting. It was a beauty!
Nicely done by Ting. You can see the frustration is usually an athlete's enemy. You don't want to be frustrated in there. You want to stay calm. You want to stay composed. And that's exactly what Khan's doing. He's consistently moving, sticking to the game plan. With 3 matches down, he knows he needs a huge win here. He definitely wants the knockout, but I think he'll take the win any way he can get it.
I'm just saying, when they asked him for a prediction, I'll probably win by decision. You focused for a calm approach to this contest from Amir Khan. Smiles at Ting as he frustrated at Ting for all this lateral movement. Quick counters and that elbow in the first round. Oh, the head kick! He almost leaned into it. That could have been tragic.
It was a beautifully timed head kick. Grazed the face there of Amir Khan. I'd like to see more of that coming from Ting.
Thanks again. Is there another head kick in the arsenal here of F-Ting? Round kick from Amir Khan. Ed powers up with the right hand. Amir breaks up. And referee Olivier Cost wants to see engagement to Amir Khan.
But I don't know if Ting or Khan is really that far ahead in the scorecards. We're seeing, you know, a lot of aggression coming from F-Ting. He's doing a lot of good work. He's starting to land these big shots right now.
I agree with you 100%, Mitch. F-Ting is the initiator. And it's a takedown. Top position now for F-Ting.
Beautiful little trip takedown to end up on top.
1-2 from half guard. Under a minute remaining. Can F-Ting posture up and work the ground and pound? They said that's how he beat Amir Khan, the GMP.
Got 45 seconds to do it. Good job by Khan to pop the hips out, but Ting socks in the legs. He's almost tried to triangle the legs. Good job by Khan to sneak one leg back out, work back up his feet. We got 30 seconds here. This 30 seconds might decide the match, Michael Chabot.
They're rallying for Amir Khan in Singapore. 20 seconds now. The cuts open up again on Ting. Looping left hand from Ting. Now engaging distance.
High kick from Amir. Ching gets on the inside. Amir closes him down.
That's it, yeah.
Final 10 seconds. Is there a knee or an elbow left? Maybe an uppercut from Ching. He's got a cut on the left arm. One under the right arm. One on the nose. And there's the end of the match. What a match from two superb athletes.
Man, that was a chess match, ladies and gentlemen. That is two high-level mixed martial artists putting on a tremendous show in Singapore. Lot of back and forth action. Ting just Amir Khan just barely got his hand up there to deflect that. Otherwise, it could have been good night to Amir Khan, but that was a back and forth matchup. We saw a lot of aggression. Yes, there was the cut that opened up in the first round from Amir Khan, but a lot of that match was the aggression coming from Evting. Evting controlling the center of that ring, pushing forward, landing shots. Oh man, that's a tough one to score.
How do you score it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, make sure you follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Judges are tabulating here ringside. Could be close. Amir Khan had a very good first round. Ting powered back with the busier. Who will close out 2019 with a win? Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the red corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner.